There's a movie. I hate to call it a movie because it's short, but there's a movie on Facebook.
Netflix.
Netflix right now.
The joint with Joey Badass.
Two Distant Strangers.
Yeah, I want to see that.
Yo,
I want to see it. Did you see it?
So I saw it.
Okay.
It's like 40 something minutes. But what happens is, he just woke up, living his life,
right.
And one nigga just wanted to fuck with him.
The cop.
And he lived that same day over and over.
Different ways.
And he tried different ways to figure it out.
Yeah.
But guess what? If
happening.
Somebody got something out for you, they got something out
and
for you.
Jason, my
and
point,
I get that point.
And,
I get
and
it.
That is what I'm alluding
to.
I'm not talking
right.
about me running a red light, bro. If I ran a red light, I didn't indicate when I turned. That's me. Yes.
You
okay.
Fucked up.
I'm not fight. I fucked up.
Okay.
Regardless, I'm going to be mad about it, but I fucked up.
Okay.
I would take my beating on my hand fine. I'm talking about when you know for a fact you're doing fuck shit as an officer. That I'm mad at that mindset as an individual first. You're not a cop first. You're not a part of this. No, you're an individual first.
Nah,
check yourself first, bro.
Nah, they're blue first, bro.
No,
but that's
no,
why I disagree. They are cops first.
No, you wake up and brush your teeth before you put on the uniform.
No, they're a cop before they brush their teeth, bro. Ask a bunch of cops how they feel.
But then guess what? Even with that, that's still a problem that you have within yourself, bro. You need to stop thinking that you're a cop first when you're not. Because all of us here, when we wake up, you say, damn, you say all the time. I say all the time. I'm a black man first. I'm not a T-Mobile employee.
Okay.
I don't work for the hospital. I'm not a doctor first. I'm a black man first.
Yes.
Same thing for any white man, Asian man, whatever you're aware of you are an individual first.
Heard it. I will say this.
Conduct yourself properly.
You out?
I will say this to just to argue that. We don't know what they say because they've always been in a place of empowerment.
And I
so wait, let me elaborate further. And what happens is we're coming from a place of, oh, I'm just a lowly black man. I'm just here. Yes, boss.
Right.
Yes, master.
Right.
We just here. They've always been coming from a place of, what's up? I own all this.
Right.
Yep.
Right.
This is my street.
These are my streets.
This is my
block.
What are you doing standing on my street? So let me finish. So what I'm saying is, you're saying when you wake up, you're a blah, blah, blah first. We don't know how the fuck they wake up. We've never been in their position.
Right.
So if I've always been running shit, and I've always been the man, and I've always been the nigga in charge, and I've always been the person who could dictate whatever happens in my day, you can't tell me how I wake up. Because I'm used to running shit.
Uh-huh.
I'm used to fucking your day up. I could do whatever I want.
No, but if that's the case, Jason, I'm going to say to the same specific point that I should be able to still tell you as a person, yo, bro, you on fuck shit. Regardless,
you can't. I'm going to tell you why you can't.
Bro.
Wait. No.
Bro,
because the same way you're saying that, we can't check the system then. Because if they are a part of the system.
Nigga, you will die.
But that is the point I'm trying to make.
You'll be the angry black man.
So what's your point?
You cannot sit here and tell me that I can't say something to the individual.
You can say what you want to say. George Floyd said a lot.
Boy, but this is all I'm saying. Maybe I'm.
And
so Michael Brown said a whole lot.
And what I'm trying to say is, regardless of what. So if I don't,
that's the point.
If the end goal is us still dying, I'm still. You know what? If I'm gonna die, I'm gonna say something.
But if you not saying nothing could keep you alive,
you'll be alive.
But then the system does nothing changes. That's all I'm saying. And I've been saying this to y'all from the beginning. I will never allow myself to be in a position where I know I didn't do anything wrong, and then I'm allow you to fuck with me. That's what I've been saying from the longest.
That's just
for example,
when the three of us
was in the car and we got pulled over, when we got, oh, he said you didn't indicate when you came out of the parking spot. And we looked at bullshit, right? Cool. And then the man said, you're not for nothing, fellas. I smell weed in the car. And then I was in the backseat like, you know damn well you don't smell no goddamn weed. You're full of shit. And y'all all looked, the both of y'all looked at me.
Because it's bullshit.
No.
We looked at you because it's easy to talk shit from the back seat.
No, wait. No.
I'm talking about bullshit.
Real quick. Let's
you're
not get too
wrong.
Hype. Let's not get too hype. What I'm saying is,
nigga said he smelled weed.
I'll tell you why it's bullshit, Bari. Because it is bullshit. And that's true. But luckily, those cops wasn't the ones that'll kill you. You don't know. And that's the part
that's... But you riling them up.
You, right. Like, and I'm sorry, bro.
What the fuck you talking about?
You're always going to be wrong
and
about
And now
this.
They're like, what the fuck?
And they're like, oh, really? This is bullshit, huh?
Step out the car, sir.
Step out the car. It's
and
bullshit,
now
right?
Now a situation
now
happens.
I'm going to show you some bullshit. You want bullshit? Bullshit here now. You know what I'm saying?
Now, you going to be here regardless.
Well, fine, but now you're giving me a reason because I'm already a dickhead. Like you say, every day I wake up.
I'm not going to let you punch me in my face with my hands tied behind my back.
If you cuff, I can do what I want.
I'm speaking figuratively, Dame.
Well, that's what I'm trying to say.
That's all I'm
saying. See how this just fake escalated?
It didn't escalate because I'm still going to do this. I'm still think the same way I think.
Cool, so I will never ride with you again. You taking me home.
I got you.
Straight. We can stop, man.
My point is, I'm going to always do that.
Bari is Dante.
In the back seat,
I'm
going to
always.
Shit.
I'm always gonna. No, you're not gonna sit here.
He looked at me. I was like, "Yo, arrest this nigga."
Mind you, when Bari said that in the back seat, what did they do? They got aggressive with us.
They did
because I'm the driver.
They was like, "Oh, really?"
So what the fuck you talking about? I'm like, "Whoa, wait a minute, sir, officer, officer. How you doing? How is your wife?
Listen,
okay,
are we cool?
Your wife and kids are right."
Like I said,
you in the back seat.
Yeah.
It don't matter. We could switch positions and I'd have said the same shit. You know damn well you don't smell no weed, bro. I'd have said the same shit. I've driven and I've said shit.
And you
what are you talking about?
Today.
They kill me. I'm 6 foot one. On,
he's
man.
The biggest person.
They're gonna shoot the shit out of me, bro.
Of what, bro. I'm not gonna see you.
They're gonna be
I'm
like, oh really?
See,
really?
I'm not gonna
do.
See any officer say some fuck shit.
What?
Do some fuck shit.
He had a gun.
Say something, bro.
He'll say, you know what? You're right. This is bullshit. Pop me.
That I'm not doing. Yeah. Maybe.
Then Bari, like, maybe, oh, not for nothing.
Maybe.
I probably should have. R.P.
He was a good dude.
Like I said, maybe my pride is too high, but I'm not going to sit here and see an officer say anything to somebody and not say something.
We big dudes.
Man, I just want to thank you so much for tuning in to Willa Wednesdays. We love and appreciate
the support. Facts.
Yeah.
If you ain't done so already, please hit the like and subscribe button for the YouTube page.
Big facts.
Yes. And click the bell for notifications.
Mm-hmm.
And make sure to join that family page, the Willa Wednesday family page on Facebook.
Mm-hmm.
Peace.
Bow.